Welcome to InterPoints. You may be looking for a way to get intersection points between common model objects. If you have primary set to face and parts, you can click on the primary and any number of parts, middle mouse, it'll appear right there. If full projection is ticked, the beam doesn't even have to be touching the face, and it will still get there. If you untick it, that'll allow you to get the intersection between a face and a curved beam accurately. You can also get intersection line between part and contour plate. The line will be created based on these settings here. If you want between a face, you can slide the face and then another face, and that line will be created based on these settings here. If you don't want to get the points, untick points, and you just get the line. If you want the intersection point between the face and construction objects, same way, face and a line, that's it, face, circle, like that, or even the face and a point. Once the items have been created in the model, if they're deleted from the model, they turn grey. The ones that are still active, you can select them in the model, you can delete them, they can turn grey. You can reinsert them back into the model again, and they'll reappear. This item list can't be saved, but it does allow you to find and delete the lines in the model to stop it from getting too cluttered. If you want to get the intersection point between a beam and the center point of a beam, not a face, you can click on vertical. Back to parts again, get point between a vertical plane and each part, select that, and that point will land in the middle. And again, if you turn full projection on, I'll create the intersection. You want to get the intersection between the face and the vertical, change the face, beam, any face you like, you can get that. If you want to get all three faces, continuous operation, beam, face, interrupt. If you want the horizontal plane of a beam, you might also need this for a column as well. You can select the horizontal plane and parts. You can either click on the beam and the two columns, that intersection, or you can click on column and the beam, and then it'll give you the same intersection. You can check the direction of the plane by clicking on vertical, so that'll go this way, or horizontal, that'll go this way, depending on the properties. If I change that to front, then that horizontal will be the other way. So this will depend on the top or front of the column as to which one you will use. You don't have to set the wet plane, but that's a good way to check it. Horizontal. Get 2 points. Objects. Horizontal. Circle. Doesn't even matter if the circle's on an angle. It's very accurate. The web plane remains as it is, so you don't have to worry about always setting your web plane back again. Sometimes you may need to get intersection points between construction objects. That's also possible. They're not always on the same level, but as long as the circles are in the same plane as each other, then this will work. Just make sure you've got objects and objects, and you can select arc and circle, and it'll create the points on the primary object. So if I select the red one and then the green one, they'll appear on the red one. If I select those two in the model, there they are there. And if I select the magenta ones, there they are there. You can also get intersection points between a circle and a line. Even if that point is not at the same level as the circle, the tangent points would be assumed that the point is level. And if you have 2 lines, it'll give you the intersection point of the 2 lines. If the 2 lines are not at the same level, it connects them with another line. And in this case, that line is not parallel, so the connecting line is perpendicular to both lines. To be as versatile as I can be, allowing a range of primary and secondary choices. You can select continuous operation if you want the command to continue until you interrupt. You can set work plane to primary if you want the primary object to receive the work plane after you've got the intersection point. You can choose whether the extra lines or points are created. The primary lines and points are always created whether that's ticked or not. You can set the work plane to different items just by clicking, just in case you need a quick work plane. You can set it to sit always on top, restore defaults, hopefully it comes in handy. Thanks for watching.